This minimalist wants more. Welcome to the Enough-ism podcast. I'm Reverend Eugen Bond, a metaphysical author and energy worker. This show challenges greater perceptions of mindfulness, meditation, and minimalism. Come along with me as I interview people from all around the world about what it means to have enough already. Find me on social media at I Am Enough-ism. Enjoy the show. This guided meditation will help unfree you and unleash your greater potential. I invite you to begin this session with the following intention. The secret to my happiness is my expansion, not my cowering inwards, but my growth now, today, tomorrow, and for the rest of my life. Allow yourself now to get comfortable in your space, sitting or reclining if you prefer, without distraction and the ability to focus fully on my voice. Let's begin with a question. Where are you right now, at this point in your life, emotionally? Are you happy, sad, stressed, excited, impatient, healing, in mourning, resilient, lonely, proud? Choose one word right now, either one that's been suggested or a new word that feels right to you in this moment, to best describe how you're generally feeling right now. This word is about how you're feeling in general, day in and day out. Now, let's go deeper. Think about this word and think about the emotion you have attached to this word. Is it positive? Is it neutral? Or is it negative? Remember that this word does not define you. It only defines a temporary state of where you are. What do you think is the cause of this emotion or the cause of this word? Is it a person, perhaps? An event that lingers in your mind? A circumstance? Societal pressure? Pressure you place on yourself or something else? Take a moment now and identify the cause of this word and the cause of the emotion it entails for you. Very good. Now, let's keep going. Consider for a moment how everyone's life, including yours, is divided into different segments, kind of like a puzzle made up of different pieces. Segments like your relationships, your career or your job, your finances, your home life, your family, your friends, your spirituality, however that's defined for you, your personal growth, your health, and so on. All of these help define who we are and what our greater purpose is. Now, identify what area of your life needs the most improvement right now, and what area of your life has the most room for growth. There is no right or wrong answer. This may be something that comes to you immediately, or it may be something you have to noodle on for a little bit. That's okay. Trust your intuition and know that you can always return to this meditation again and revisit it at a later time if you need to. Throughout your life, all of these different segments of your life will shift. Maybe right now, your romantic relationship section feels very full and very strong. Or maybe right now it feels empty. Whatever your sector is that you've chosen, acknowledge right now that this section feels empty in this moment. And that is okay. The fact that this section is empty for you does not define you. It does not define your self-worth. For your life is fluid, and all these sections are fluid as well. Perhaps there was a time in your life when this particular section of your life was full, overflowing, and abundant. If this is not the case, acknowledge that there is a time in the future, a time you don't know now as being a tangible time, but there is a time in the future when this area of your life that is empty will be full, overflowing with abundance. And I say will as a very powerful choice of words. It is a word full of power as well. Take this time right now to whisper or say to yourself, either out loud or just within your mind, the following sentence. I am expanding, and my life is expanding. Repeat this right now. Very good. Now, let's go on a bit of a visual journey together. Imagine yourself now as a hot air balloon stuck on the ground. There are straps where your feet are that have yet to be untied. You, as a hot air balloon, represents you with a state of your life that is empty. You feel stuck. The reality is, all you have to do is untie the straps. Once untied, you will be free, flying up and up above the clouds. Acknowledge to yourself right now that this day will come. It may not be here yet as something you can taste or touch or smell or hear or see, but one day it will come. This day will be one of the most important days in your entire life when you finally have what you desire. The reality is that you are already on your way to achieving this. What you have to do is adjust your mindset. Think of it kind of like you're changing a radio station. All you have to do is turn the dial just a little bit to the left or to the right to switch the frequency and switch the station in your mind that you are listening to. Imagine just for a brief moment right now with me that you have this specific area of your life filled up to the max of abundance. The circumstances of how this has happened isn't important. So don't worry about that. Instead, think about the emotion. Right now, in your mind's eye, reach down to your feet and untie the straps that hold you down. It's simple, really. All you have to do is reach down and unbuckle it. Feel your feet loosen from the pressure. Feel your heart lighten. You feel yourself lifting up and up. You are a beautiful hot air balloon. The wind is carrying you up above the clouds slowly. You feel so peaceful. The sunlight is beating down on your face gently. You feel its warmth. You feel connected to everything that is. This hot air balloon represents you right now. All you have to do is untie what holds you down. This act of untying is a simple act. If these words are hard for you to hear, it's okay. Let them sit with you. The reason why I say it is a simple act is because what it comes down to is you changing your mindset. This is indeed a simple act. And it will become your mission and your sense of purpose to make it a simple act. When you feel emotional, when you feel as if your thoughts do not align with this hot air balloon lifting, but instead your thoughts align with the idea of being tied down, you will recognize this. You will say to yourself, this thought that I have right now is not me. It is a thought, and I have the power to untether myself from this thought, just as you have the power to untether your feet from the straps. This is what I mean when I say it is a simple act to change your mindset. It is like a muscle. You will get better as you practice, and you are already practicing right now. Imagine this area of your life, the area you focused on, the one word you defined to categorize this part of your life is filled up to the max. Let go of the how or why or what must happen to get there. For this is beyond your control. The universe, whatever that means for you, whether you believe this to be God with a capital G, energy, a higher power, destiny, or something else, whatever you define that is does not matter. What does matter is that the universe has your back, and you will manifest what you desire. Right now, at this exact moment in time, as you hear my words, you are in a beautiful moment of transition. If you were born onto this earth and immediately received everything you ever wanted, and all of your life's puzzle pieces were full already, consider that you perhaps wouldn't be happy. For this is not our purpose. In this lifetime, we must experience the yin and the yang, the good and the bad, the dark and the light. This contrast is critical, for this contrast is what makes us grow and heal and progress and advance. This contrast is what makes us strong and resilient, wanting to seize the day, wanting to better ourselves and improve our lives each and every day. No matter who you are, your age, your race, what you consider home, your gender, your identity, what you value, no matter who you are, you have the power to change your own life. When you think of where you want to be versus where you are right now, you have the power to close that gap. Society teaches us that this kind of transition comes in the form of overnight successes. Sometimes this may be the case. Most of the time it is not. And the reality is, oftentimes it takes decades for someone to become that overnight success. Progress is beautiful. The unknown is beautiful. Yes, the unknown can be terrifying. It can be scary. It can make us doubt ourselves. It can make us question our sense of worth. Make it your mission right now to never question your sense of worth, to never question your value. There is a light inside of you that no one can ever take away. That light is you, the true you, the you stripped away, not the you that is your body, not the you that is your name, your identity, your job. That you is the you before you came to this earth, and that you is the you that will follow you into eternity. Although the journey of life we all share may be hard, and then even harder, there is so much beauty in your journey left to experience. I believe, and so must you, that something incredible will happen to you soon. You may not know what this is right now at this moment, but I believe, and so must you, that goodness is on its way to you. The process is happening. You have initiated it, and I am so proud of you. Are you proud of yourself? Tell yourself yes right now in your heart. The experience you desire, whatever it is, will set you on a new path and point you closer to where you desire to be. It is up to you and no one else except for you, to have an open heart and an open mind, to be receptive for happiness and joy to enter your life, to want expansion, to be comfortable with being uncomfortable, for that is how you will grow. The ultimate secret to life is this, and nothing more. Happiness and joy is about expanding rather than shrinking. It is about growth rather than remaining stagnant. It is about flying through the clouds untethered rather than standing still. It is about leaving your comfort zone, not fearfully, but boldly, because you want to, because you need to, and taking tiny steps every day, no matter how small, to redesign your life and your role in it. I may not know you, but I believe in you deeply and in your potential. We are both connected because we all want the same things. You are expanding and your life is expanding, and this meditation is a starting point for you. I challenge you, and I know you can do it, to be relentless in your desire to expand outwards and upwards. This is your life's purpose, and you are ready for this challenge. I know you are. Your expansion doesn't need to be a grand expansion that is loud for all to see with bells and whistles. This expansion can just be this expansion can just be this expansion is between you and the universe. This expansion is a decision you make right now, and this decision will shape the rest of your life. Is enough, and so are you. Enough-ism is about your ability to be unselfish and to be untethered and to fly away. This minimalist wants more. Welcome to the Enough-ism podcast. I'm Reverend Eugen Bond, a metaphysical author and energy worker. This show challenges greater perceptions of mindfulness, meditation, and minimalism. Come along with me as I interview people from all around the world about what it means to have enough already. Find me on social media at I Am Enough-ism. Enjoy the show.